And never before has this happened. It has never happened before. See, the people who were born in the 40s were struggling with the war, the aftermath of the war. People like us who grew up in the 60s were looking at shortages. When I went abroad for the first time, I was allowed to take $8. That was all that we were allowed, and some pre form from the Reserve Bank, etc. Today, there is no issue. Money is available. What you need is ideas, leadership, really something. And actually, the answer is very simple. Whatever are the pain points, the one thing about creating new solutions, I'm not even saying whether it's your own enterprise or whatever, is what is a pain for somebody else is an opportunity for you. Typically, the electricity is not coming right, you create inverters. People say water is not fit for drinking, you create water kind of thing. So the worry about technology versus the case, the technology person uses what it knows to overcome problems. And if these solutions are valuable to people, they will pay for it in one way or the other. And you realize that, and you see what a real CEO looks like on this side. So I wish you all the best.
That is world's number one off-road vehicle company. He joined Polaris India at the time of company's inception in January 2011. Mr. Dubey is the alumnus of University of Allahabad and Indian Institute of Management, Kolkata. Now I request Mr. Pankaj Dubey, sir, for his address.
Partner and our fellow colleagues from DIAS and the youth of today who is going to shape and become CEOs tomorrow. It's a privilege to be here and sharing platform with such dignified and accomplished leaders of the country. And I'm very happy about the institution who thought about such meet, because I have been in so many meets across the country in premier institutes as well. In IIT, I am as well, but I haven't seen any conference of this level having thought of also. So it's really good that this thought came and is getting implemented. Just a couple of decades back, I was sitting in your place and listening and thinking what I have to do, what this should be my dream, which industry I should join, what I should do. So all these questions were there in my mind as well. And I kept accomplish a lot of things, and by just listening to other people, and it's always that I wanted to do something big. So I never settled for anything small. So just like to share about my company, because when I got a call from Dr. Sunil, and he said that this is the IT industry leaders CEO forum, so I refused. I said I am not Polaris software, so I am from an automobile. He said no, there is a convergence taking place. So he convinced me, and I am glad that you convinced me to be here. So I have a small video to play, which is about tell you about the company. There are a number of things, and it started off, when we started off, the question was where we should sell, who would buy, is there a market in India? There's nobody, and no company wants to sell this product in India. Even 4.5 years of work, only Polaris is the company which has taken this initiative. We have competitors internationally who are present in India, have not got into this segment, and now slowly they are getting into this. This is just to show you the technology, the products, and many of you would have seen this. I just saw in your booklet that you went to Dubai for some event, and I'm sure that you would have seen Polaris vehicles over there for mobile phone. Now, similarly, in the transportation segment also, I foresee that this is going to happen, and I'm going to share with you one of the things that we have done, innovation in India, that we will share with you. Now, all the future of transportation design, you know, what they do is basically they want to conserve the resource and merge technologies. So most of the products that you see from Polaris are very IT friendly now. Now, with this, I would like to switch over to another point, because I saw that there are a lot of students out here, and we heard a lot of things this morning. And so I prepared one slide for all of you, which is about the advice to youth. You know, we heard from Dr. Pant about energy. You know, I firmly believe that each one of us is also a form of energy. So what you can do is immense. So what human beings can do is immense. I mean, I would like to at some point of time come back to you to deliver a 90-minute lecture on this. But surely, when you hear that, you will be convinced that, I mean, this is what we are. We all hear about that we are souls, we are atma, and all that. And, you know, this is, and we mistake it with our body, that we are Pankaj Dubey is this body. No, it's not. This is what I would like to teach all of you, that please respect females, not only reading the scriptures and book, but in practical life as well. Thanks a lot.
Senior management consultant, former vice president at CA, former CEO in Infosys BP, a well-balanced and respected business leader with multiple industry experience in various functional areas. He's a person extended for profitability, turnaround, startups, managing large operations, teams with global organizations like Siemens, GE, IBM, and Infosys. Now I request Bhatiaji for his remarks.
Yes, sir.
Show some energy.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I was traveling a lot, and I you would have heard that after 25 years in corporate life, I decided to do something on my own, and you know, whatever I've learned in those 25 years, I'm trying to drive my passion, contribute to field of health and education in India. So I have been keeping very busy, and but you know, I must appreciate Dr. Sunil's perseverance. And even yesterday I called him, and I'm not able to make it. And I have not even he prepared some presentation for me, and I said I'm not even there. And so today morning I just went through some of them, and I was not sure what will I talk to you, but with such distinguished people talking, I have made some notes and tried to make some sense out of it. You know, you and me can innovate and think of, you know, our applications, our data will sit very securely on those clouds without any, you know, without the security hassles, without any other thing. So this is the trend, but I'm not here to talk about this. You know, I think there are very interesting discussions which has been happening, and on the innovation, on the transformation, and on the sustainability. So I coined some word, I think, ISI, and I'm a very big fan of acronyms. So this ISI is not the one in which we know, and which either this side of the border or that side of the border, we have two ISIs which all of us know. But this ISI, I would say, innovation, sustainability, and impact. And I just, with these two presentations, I was trying to summarize it. So if we continue to innovate, it's very important to see the impact of that. Beaten them black and blue. I think I bought my BlackBerry phone, I got my official BlackBerry some 10 years, 12 years back when it came. But then, you know, my daughter pushed me to buy a BlackBerry at that point of time, because BBM was, it was hitting the youth young generation. And then suddenly mobile phone, smartphones came into it. The point I'm saying is, one, you make an innovation which is impactful, and then continue to innovate more. I think Apple is able to, these days, do some good work as far as maintaining the sustainable part of it. You know, he was perceived to be a very arrogant person in his first life. But I think he used to think from his mind and think from the other way around. So, this is something which might be helpful. Now, touching, you know, about the opportunity that I, as professor said in the beginning, do either health or education for the country, and I wish you all the best. You do well tonight.
Thank you, sir. Shri Anurag Gaur, Director, Office, SMB Business, Microsoft India. With about 2 decades of experience, a marketing professional who's built key marketing competencies to lead the marketing discipline. He is a winner of CMO Asia Award for the Best B2B Campaign, Microsoft's Gold Star Award, and Chairman's Cash Award from Microsoft for leading Windows 8 and Windows Server marketing campaigns in India. Now I request Anurag sir for his address.
A lot of coaching from Mr. Pant and Mr. Bhatia and Mr. Dubey on how to look at, whether it's looking at the UN's resolution taking on the 20th September, and shaping your learning, your education, so that you be skilled in the relevant areas, or whether it is the very useful mentoring, very useful coaching advice that you've gotten from both Mr. Bhatia as well as Mr. Dubey on how to respect your teachers and how to conduct yourself in face of opposition and in face of a no, and how to therefore learn and grow. So let me now try to put all of that together and share a few more ideas about how the world is changing. In fact, it's now a giant network, and there's a little bit of dissonance in this word that the world is a network. My point is that the world has always been a network. We've had a postal network, we've had a railways network. Human beings, hum log social animals, and we cannot live without each other. We cannot live without a network. In fact, the worst punishment I'm told is solitary confinement. Jail mein akele aadmi ko band kar do, apne aap ke saath hi khatam ho jayega. We are, for us as social people, for us as network people, what technology has come and done is remove the inefficiencies from it. Whether you see a WhatsApp, or whether you see a Facebook, or whether you see a Twitter, it's just making it easier for you to connect with people, share ideas, share content, call people, and share your videos and all of that, whether it's YouTube, whether it's Google. People look at inefficiencies in a network, in an existing problem, and then build a more efficient, simpler solution. Whether you call it, you identify a pain, and then you build for a solution for that pain, as Mr. Bhatia was talking about. Essentially, the problems that you all will see as engineering students or management students, and if you have to have that Saraswati and Lakshmi convergence, you have to figure out what are the inefficiencies in the system, and how do you make it more efficient? How does your idea make it more efficient, and therefore provides an ease, a comfort, or a gain, a benefit to the audiences, or to the intended audience, to the intended customer, and therefore then becomes it sustainable for you to run that for some time till someone finds an inefficiency in your system, and then takes on from there. Relevant to you all, people say ubiquitous connectivity, har jagah connectivity. People say any internet, India can each other, but hey, look around yourselves. Everyone has an internet connected phone, and that phone, even to the healthcare solution that Mr. Bhatia is working at, it will be that simple little phone that will provide the last mile connectivity, because India, with 1.2 billion people, has about what, 1.1 billion phones already? That's the cheapest way, that's the cheapest solution for people to get that amount of, that touch of connectivity, that touch of technology to remove inefficiencies from their lives and their systems. Look what Airbnb has done, it's removed inefficiencies in the transport system. Gurgaon mein transport hai nahi, auto rickshaws hote nahi the. Ola and Uber has allowed me to de-risk it, and it gives me a sense of safety. When my wife is traveling in an Ola cab or a Uber cab, I get that sense of safety, I can track her. So those are fun things. The technology is removing all of those pains, and is removing all that ATM and all of those things, make it easy for you to pay, make it easy for you to purchase. Flipkart, look at what it has done for the hardware industry. Everything is moved to the digital world. So those ideas are there. Drivers are there, it's just keep thinking, keep dreaming, realize your full potential, and have a great day. Big thank you.
Views of industry leaders who are participating in leading organizations and providing directions to IT industry. It was planned to prepare an archive for reference to others. We are happy to share that we received high quality articles from leading professionals of the organizations of repute, including the message from Ministry of State for Statistics and Program Implementation, General B.K. Singh. Honorable Padma Bhushan, Dr. F.C. Kohli, who is regarded as the father of IT industry in India and founder CEO, former Deputy Chairman, TCS and former President of NASCOM. Dr. Ajit Abraham, renowned scientist and director MIR Labs, Washington, USA. And articles from experts from leading organizations including Oracle, IBM, GSMA, Puget, NIT Technologies, NIT Limited, Red Hat, Birlasoft, Accenture, Prologic, Dinago Telecom, and many more. These articles have been printed in the form of a book with an ISBN number. Now may I take this opportunity to request all the dignitaries on the dais to release the souvenir. May I also request Secretary ITS, the Education Group, Sri V.K. Arora sir, Chief Administrator ITS, the Education Group, Sri Srinagar Sood sir, and eminent speakers of today's meet, Sri Pavan Maradi sir, Sri Bhagwan Kumadi, Dr. Devrat Nair, Mr. S. Sridhar, and Mr. Satyanarayan Venkataraman, to join us for this release of Souvenir.
Thank you.